Hey y'all, so today we're going to talk about PV Direct. What is it? How does it work? Why do you want to use it? And all that good stuff. So this is going to be a bit of a long video. If this is not something you're interested in, please skip. It's going to be pretty detailed. I've tried to make this video in the past. It ends up becoming pretty long and I've never posted it because of that reason. But there are people that are very interested in this. So I want to get the video out. If it's not something you're interested in, please just go ahead and skip. So PV Direct, what is it? First of all, PV Direct is simple. It is literally taking your solar panels and connecting them to a load. So in this picture you guys see here, remember I'm not an artist, but you got, let's say these are 200 watt panels each. They're connected in series. They're 24 volt panels. They go down from into a breaker. Out of that breaker, let's just say it's a 15 amp breaker, into this fan, right? And so what happens is when obviously the sun's up, that fan turns on and starts running. That's PV Direct in the basic form. So there's multiple ways of using PV Direct. Usually you're going to see it being used as to run a motor or to heat something. So for a heating element. Obviously it's not going to work for lighting and things like that that are on demand because, you know, you need light at nighttime when there's no sun and all that kind of stuff. So why would you want PV Direct? PV Direct is amazing because two things. One, it's going to save you a lot of money. How's it going to save you a lot of money? That's because it's not going to be using your batteries. So you're avoiding batteries altogether because obviously batteries are the most expensive component in your solar for an off-grid setup. Next, it also helps you prevent using your batteries as much. So not only are you having to buy less batteries for your off-grid setup, but you're also not using your batteries that you have as much for the loads, because again, PV Direct, you're not connected to batteries at all. So how does it work? Like I just said, you've got the fan idea. That works really well. Basic idea of that, and this is the way I've used it in the past, is we take a fan motor. What I used was a radiator fan out of an old pickup truck and connected it in the eave of the house, or whatever the thing is on the side of the house, I can't remember. And it was in a small cabin that I had out in the woods. And the problem with it is in the south, we get so much moisture that the cabin would just, I started having a little bit of a mold issue. Well, I didn't want to put a hole in the roof to put one of those whirly birds up there. And my friend suggested an attic fan. But the problem with that was, is the house was, the cabin was totally DC. So no inverters or anything like that. So what I ended up doing was goofing around one day and literally took that fan and plugged it into the solar panel, and that fan came on and it was ripping. I was like, hey, this is really cool. So basically, I ended up screwing that fan inside the house on the gable end, that's what it's called, on the inside of the gable, pointed it outward, and when the sun came up, that fan came on and would run, and when the sun would go down, that fan would turn off, and I never had moisture problems again. Now, in the wintertime, even though we live in the south, today is the 13th of December. It's 70 degrees, which is kind of weird. But yeah, I'm out in shorts. Just a couple of days ago, it was 30 degrees or 32 degrees. So our weather is crazy. But anyways, it's 94% humidity right now today. So it explains to you guys why we have such humidity problems. But obviously, I didn't want that fan running all the time in the wintertime. So what I ended up doing is putting a little DC timer in there. And it would only allow it to run, I think, three times a week. So if there was sun available and the timer said it was okay, it would let the fan run and dry out the attic. Worked amazing. Then the other way I used PV Direct was, and this one I don't suggest the way I initially did it, and I'll explain why. But I had four Kyocera panels, actually these same ones back here behind me, four Kyocera panels connected in series. And then they ran down straight into, I had a 40 gallon water tank, just a grid electric on demand, you know, electric water tank. And what I did was I took the DC straight out of the solar panels, connected it straight to the hot water heating element. Cause I just wanted to see if it would work. And sure enough, it actually made hot water. Now, I don't suggest that because obviously you don't have a thermostat. You could make a big bomb. There's all kinds of dangerous stuff. Don't do that. That's not what I was suggesting. I'm just explaining that's how I initially figured it out. So it would make hot water for me. So then eventually, when I realized, okay, this is going to work, I tried originally using the AC thermostat that's built into the hot water. Don't do that. Bad idea. AC has a small arc. DC has a big arc. And it almost burned down that hot water heater before I caught it in time. So don't do that. Don't use the breaker or the thermostat built in. What I ended up doing was I ended up using what's called a snap disk. And it's basically a DC rated thermostat. And I slapped it on the side of the hot water element, a hot water tank. And then it would just turn on and off if there was enough sun and the water got hot enough, which, you know, usually did because I was only there when I wasn't, you know, when I was home, when I wasn't working. So by the time I got home, I always had plenty of hot water. But anyways, we turn on and off according to the temperature of the water. The problem with that guy was, is every, I don't know, 6 months to a year, I was replacing that little snap disc because it was moving a lot and they're not designed to be used so many times. It would always be breaking. I mean, it was super cheap. It was like $3 and it took me a whole 5 minutes to fix it, but it was quite annoying. So eventually what I ended up doing was I found a DC hot water element that had a literal built-in heating element in the back of that. And I'll leave a link for those. They're still available. And what it did was, it was 48 volts, I think. And it worked exactly the same. It just had two wires coming out. You screwed it into the side of the tank and you just dialed the number you wanted and it was done. So that made hot water for me. And guys, even if you're on grid, that right there can save you a lot of money. The average American, the second biggest power load in their home is hot water. First is climate control and then hot water. If you ran, let's say, 2,000 watts or 1,500 watts of solar panels on your roof and connected it to just one heating element in the bottom of your tank and left the top one on the grid, that could save you a lot of money because hot water is, like I said, generally the second most expensive thing on your loads. And again, you don't need any batteries or anything like that. The other way, and this is actually how I got into solar, was doing well pumps. So well pumps, DC direct, have been around for a very long time. And basically what it is the solar panels go into a little controller, and then the controller takes that DC voltage, it usually turns it into AC, but not all the time, and runs the well pump. Now remember, there's no batteries involved. What it would do is it would run the well pump, fill up a big tank and a cistern above, you know, a couple thousand gallons, how much ever it was. Some of them were huge tanks. I mean, some of them were millions of gallons. But anyways, these well pumps would kick on from the DC direct pumps, or in this case, it might be AC, but it would turn these pumps on, fill up these cisterns or tanks, and then at night or when people needed water, the gravity would feed down the pressure and the gravity from having so much water in a big tank would feed down into their home, run their loads in their home, their showers and all that kind of stuff. In some cases, we did have to have an external 120 volt or 240 volt pump that ran to move the water because they didn't have enough height difference in the water tank. But the idea is you just make hay when the sun is shining, right? So you're just filling that tank when the sun's available. You're not using your batteries. You're not putting any loads on your system. It's literally just its own little system. A lot of those have floats in them and stuff so that you can fill up like a 1,000-gallon tank. And once the 1,000-gallon tank's full, it turns off the pump. So those are some of the very basic setups that you can do with running a DC direct or PV direct, however you want to see it. People call it different things. And guys, this is a great opportunity to really save you some money. Like I said, it's going to prevent you from having to buy as many batteries, first of all. And second of all, you're not working your batteries as hard. So, you know, your batteries are going to last physically longer because you're not working them as hard. So there you have it. There's some things you can do with PV Direct. Hopefully that helps some of you guys. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, know what to leave them below. Thanks a lot. Take care. And God bless.